Friends, we have been discussing the accusative case. I is the marker for the accusative case. You are familiar with that. In the previous class, we were considering the words ending with "-um". Like manayam, manam. When we add I, it doesn't go well as manamai. So the grammarians have included one suffix atthu before adding I. So this became mana atthu and I, that is manattai. So also puttagam. What is puttagam? A book. Puttagam plus I, you apply the same rule, it becomes puttagattai. With that, we can make a sentence. Puttagattai padi. Puttagam plus I, puttagattai padi. As I explained earlier, when you have a plosive, that is a hot sound, after I, that is accusative case marker, it is doubled. Suppose instead of padi, I use another verb, kal. Kal means again to study. Puttagattai kal. So all the words ending with "-um", will take attu before accepting the case marker I. This is one set of words which have "-um" at the end, and invariably they take attu before accepting I. We shall take up another set. I will go for persons. First person singular is non. Second person singular is me. When we started studying words, that is combining letters and making words out of the combination, we learned that non becomes N. Ni becomes un. Non as it is a nominative case. If you have to apply any other case to that, it undergoes a change and becomes n. For instance, I is in the nominative case. If you want to have any other case added to it, you have to change it as my or me. My genitive case, me for the accusative case. So also in Tamil, non becomes n before accepting any case marker. Ni becomes one. What is the plural of non? Nam. Plural of ni? Neengal. Now let me check up whether you do remember some of the words we had already studied. Non becomes n, ni becomes un, and nom, I do remember we did read earlier. Nom becomes nam. So also ningal becomes ungal. These are the forms of the personal nouns belonging to first person and second person to be included in any sentence having a case. We are discussing the accusative case, and the case marker for this one is I. What will happen? In conjunction, we did come across such a situation. For instance, kan is a word. It has a consonantal vowel and ends with a consonant. And you added om. That is the conjunction. If there is only one letter before a consonant, we saw that the consonant will get doubled, and so it will be kannum. We apply this rule here also. This is a two-lettered word, a short vowel and a consonant, and a vowel is to be added. So n plus I will become ni. N plus I, ni. The rule is the doubling of this consonant under the circumstances. So also, 1 plus I will become unnai. Can you read this? Naan unnai paarkiren. आई सी यू. द वर्ब कम ओनली एट द एंड. नान उन्नई पार्क्रेन. आई सी यू. दिस इज द एक्यूसेटिव फॉर्म ऑफ मी. Suppose I have this me here, that is you, and I would like to have the same verb here, you see me. What will be the form? You, me. Ennai, yes, for ik he hope you remember the suffix oi ni ennai paarkirai. Is change. Me is the nominative case. That is the subject of the verb parkirai. Par is the verb, kiru is the present tense marker, and oi stands for me. Ennai, me. You see me. I have changed slightly. Naan, nominative case. Parkiren, again you have to remember the three elements here. Naan unnai parkiren. I see you. First person plural is both nom and nangal. Nom becomes nam and nangal becomes yengal. Nam becomes nam, nangal becomes yengal. And second person plural, neengal becomes ungal. What will happen if you add I? Because it's a two-lettered word with a short vowel and a consonant, it gets doubled. It becomes nammai. Nam becomes nam before taking up the case marker. Nam, nam plus I, doubling. Nammai. Now we go to nangal. Nangal becomes yengal in the beginning. And I add the marker. What will happen? Nothing will happen. There will be a normal blending of a consonant with the vowel. That is, yengal plus I, yengalai, us. the consonant at the end of this word took up I and it became a consonantal vowel. So also second person plural neengal becomes ungal. When it takes I, it becomes ungalai. அவர் உங்களை அழைக்கிறார். அழை டு கால் ஆர் டு இன்வைட். அவர் உங்களை அழைக்கிறார். அழை இஸ் டு கால் ஆர் டு இன்வைட். அவர் the honorific singular for third person, ungalai second person plural, and also second person honorific singular. Avar ungalai alaikkirar. Avar gets or as its personal marker. Alai is the verb and kiru is the present tense marker. Avar ungalai alaikkirar. Avar is third person, honorific singular or plural. What is the singular? Avan or aval. Avan is masculine gender, aval is feminine gender. I add I, what will happen? The combination will be a smooth one. This consonant accepts the vowel naturally without any difficulty. So this becomes avanai. So also aval plus I will become avalai. Avan masculine gender plus I avanai. Aval plus I avalai. This is third person singular, masculine and feminine. This is third person singular, neuter gender. And when we see adu, naturally we remember idu and edu. You remember that? Adu, that. Idu is this and edu is which. So they go together. Whatever happens to adu will happen to idu and edu. I add I. What will happen? Naturally this must become adai. Adu plus I must become adai. Logically, it is all right, and it's being used like that. But the grammarians had a different opinion from the very beginning. So they said adu will take one suffix in between, that is adu will become adu plus an and then I, that is to say adanai. The grammarians have insisted upon an being added to adu, idu and edu. So idu will become idanai. Adu will become with an adanai. Idu will become with an idanai. This has been the standpoint of the grammarians, and the literature, right from the earliest literature up to this day, this form is employed in writing. You must have come across the name Thirukkural. Thirukkural. You would have come across this name. This is a very famous book of about 2000 years old, more than that even. A book which the whole humanity can be proud of. Such a beautiful work. This was written by Thiruvalluvar. Thiruvalluvar is the author of this immortal Thirukkural. Now, I add I what will happen? There will be a natural combination. Thirukkural plus I, Thirukkuralai. Thirukkuralai, Thiruvalluvar. திருக்குறளை திருவள்ளுவர் எழுதுகிறார். Because you have learnt only the present tense, I am using the present tense Semba. Thiruvalluvar, nominative case, it goes up first. Thiruvalluvar, Thirukkuralai ezhuthugirar. Now, I have placed them in such a way that the sense will not change even if I put one noun before the other. Thiruvalluvar subject, Thirukkuralai object, ezhuthugirar verb. Thirukkuralai object because of I, Thiruvalluvar ezhuthugirar. Now, you have learnt two important things, that is to say, the grammarians have fixed certain rules which are being followed for more than 2000 years. And also, you have learnt the spelling of Thirukkural, the immortal Tamil work, and the name of the author. In the next class, will continue in the same way and also see one Thirukkural means one piece or one couplet of Thirukkural.